第一集。
Good evening, my friends. Most of the places where I went for lecture, people often ask me, how old are you? They don't ask for enlightenment. They ask, how old are you? Some people even say to me, oh, you look like a child. How much do you know? So I said to them, not much, not much. Just enough to take you to heaven. Yes. Actually, heaven doesn't belong to me alone. Heaven or nirvana doesn't belong to Buddhists alone, doesn't belong to Christians alone, doesn't belong to Hindus or whatever religions we may name in this world. Heaven is the state of tranquility, of desirelessness, of everything fulfilled of its own accord. And we call that also nirvana. Actually, when the Buddha was alive, he tried to break up the false conception of heaven by divided it into many different states. So we have kind of lower heavens and higher heavens. And the highest, the Buddha say, nirvana. Okay. We can call that the kingdom of God. The kingdom of God is what? And what is Buddha nature? And nirvana and all that, it sounds very far-fetched and very strange. And most of the myths of the practicings like yoga, meditation, or religious penance make people feel that it is difficult to meditate. It is difficult to attain God. It is so difficult to attain Buddhahood. Actually, it is not that. True religion belongs to all people. God belongs to all beings. You might call it Buddha nature if you wish, or Buddhahood if you wish. This is a common property of everyone. To some beings, even hell belongs to them. To some beings, only nirvana, only heaven, I mean the kingdom of God, belongs to them. Hell belongs to someone else. To some, they possess both hell and heaven. To some others, they possess only hell, so-called hell. I will explain soon. Now we should try to understand and explain it in a very scientific way and logical way, so that the myths of all these far-fetched heavens can be brought down to earth and let people have a close look at these so-called places. I may liken the hell and heaven, or goodness, positive energy, just like energies. Now, in the universe, all matter, all things are created by energies. And we call that creative force, or we might call it the creator. And all the energies have now scattered all over places in the universe and became different worlds and different beings. And now these beings, they will acquire their individual state of thinking or level of consciousness. And according to the interreactions between each other, they will generate another kind of energy. This kind of energy, we will divide it into two categories. The first one, we can call it positive energy, or we say God nature, heavenly force, or Buddha nature. The second category, we can call it negative power or evil force, or dark force, or opposite of goodness. Now the goodness and the positive energy are side by side with the negative. Whenever any beings, be they angelic beings or earthling, the worldly people, whenever they generate goodness, tolerance, loving, compassion, and cooperation with each other, then these energies will be categorized as good, or God force, positive power. And then the more we think, the more the beings generate this kind of goodness, the more positive power we have in our atmosphere or in our world. And whenever we or any beings generate hatred, bad thoughts, and any kind of negative tendencies, actions, or speech, we added more into the negative storehouse of the atmosphere, which is we call evil force. And this force will breed more hatred, more wars, more disharmony in our world, or in any world that these people happen to reside. That is the reason why we should generate always goodness in thoughts, in deeds, and in speech, in order to derive the goodness that we have sown. So that's why in the Bible it is stated that as you sow, so shall you reap. And in the Buddhist scriptures, it's the same thing. If you do good deeds, you get a good result. If you do bad, then you reap the result thereof. Most of the scriptures mention the same things. Now, in order to reach heaven, it is logical. Now we know that we have to tune into goodness, to the positive part of the world. And the more we step into goodness, the nearer to goodness, the more we are merged into this heavenly quality, the more we are near to heaven. Negative force may exist in our neighborhood, but it will not affect us. For example, we have lights in our house, neon lamps, and outside of our house may be darkness. But when we step into our house and stay there, we can read, we can work, we can play, we can see our beloved ones and all the surrounding. The darkness outside will not affect our light inside the house. So that is a very simple and kind of a basic explanation about good and evil, heaven and hell. If the negative power is so strong, then it created a kind of very condensed atmosphere, and whoever happened to be drawn into it by his own or her own actions, then he will experience the so-called hell, where the most intense agonies repentance, guilty feeling will torture them until they have paid off the bad thinking or deeds that they have done before. We can avoid that. We can avoid this stage of agony, which is called hell, if we turn into goodness now. There are two kinds of heaven. One is temporary and one is permanent. The so-called temporary heaven can be earned by doing good deeds, by avoiding evils, and by practicing religious penance or believing in some religion or the God of your faith, and prayers and reading scriptures and trying to live accordingly as much as you can. Another kind of heaven or kingdom we call the ultimate kingdom of God. It is the permanent, eternal, everlasting one. That requires more effort, and that requires the grace of the Almighty or the Buddha nature, the Buddha, Buddha, yes. For the Buddhists, Buddha is the highest. For the Christian, God is the highest. Actually, both of them are the same. We will not want to argue about that. In some of the books that my disciple have written for you, I think I have explained more detail, more clearly, and in the space of 2 or 3 hours, I would not like to debate over this anymore. But just to offer you a solution to better your life, to live a more fulfilled existence, whether you are Buddhist or Christians or Sikhs or Hindu, it doesn't matter. Goodness is only goodness. Negative is negative for all religious people alike, for all beings alike. Just like darkness is for all nationalities alike, and light is for all nationalities is also alike. There is no difference between English perception of light or African perception of light. The benefit is the same. If you put the same neon lamp into an English house and put that lamp into an African tribe house, both of them know that it is light. Doesn't matter if they communicate with each other or not. There's no need to explain that is light. And if he step outside in the jungle, he knows it's darkness. He might express it in different names, different terms, but darkness still prevails. So similarly, goodness or heavenly quality or Buddha nature is the same for every of us. And should we desire to live a heavenly life and to earn the kingdom of God afterward, we have many ways to do it. The most simple is to have faith in your religion. Practice what your religion teaches you. Practice, practice, not talk, not preaching, but practice. Practice yourself. Keep the commandments of God if you are Christians. Keep the 5 precepts of the lay Buddhist practitioners, and keep other religious precepts according to your religious order. First, keep them, practice them. Practice goodness, practice compassion, love, charity. I think Singapore seems to be a very good place. All the religions are in harmony with each other, and everyone is free to do his own work and to believe in his own religious faith without feeling controlled or agitated by the neighbor. The government of Singapore deserve our praise for the wise ruling system that at the moment prevails in this country. And the country is so clean, so fine, so green, and people are happy. And I think we can live in harmony with each other in every country like this. Every country should be like this, at least for the earth people. Then we have no war and no hatred and no troubles. The money that the people pay for tax should be contributed to the common good of the citizens. It's like in Singapore, for example. Then people would be happy. Now, that means the people here in Singapore truly practice to some extent the religions that they profess. But there are some more advanced religious practice that to some intense truth of God-searching persons, the ordinary practices seem not to be enough. To these people, we would like to offer the method of Guanyin, which is the contemplation of the inner power, God power, or the Buddha nature. This Buddha nature let itself be known by a kind of soundless sound, kind of vibrationless vibration, and lightless light. Because in that light, there is no shadow. Everything is clear and doesn't impede each other. In this sound, we only hear wisdom. Actually, I cannot say hear because we don't hear it with the ear. What the Tao Te Ching say, this is called Tao. The Tao, we don't need the ears, but we can hear it. We don't need the eyes, but we can see it. Because this is the lightless light, the shadowless light, and the noiseless sound. Therefore, we don't need the ears, but we can hear them. These are the things that are stated in the scriptures, but we do not experience them because we don't know how to go about reaching them. So like in the Christian Bible, it is says some saints have seen God. Like God is like a big flame, right? Big light, or like a white dove that descends from heaven. And God spoke in the sound, like the sound of thunder, like the sound of many waters. And then it say, in the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. And everything was created by this Word, and nothing that was created that is not from this Word. Now, what is this Word? This is the sound that I have just mentioned, the noiseless sound, the vibration, the sound of God, the sound of thunder, the sound like many thousand waters. This we can hear through proper guidance. And this flame, God appear like flame, God appear like light. This we can see through proper guidance. And this we want to offer to the serious seekers after the truth, to the one who would like to devote his meaningful life to God, to seek the kingdom of God, which is within himself, according to Bible statement. And the ones who like to seek the Buddha nature, the Buddha within himself, which is also stated in the Buddhist scriptures. We heard all this, we read all this, but we do not experience. Just because in the olden times, the communication system was not perfect, was not on a large scale, and one continent doesn't know the next. But at the present, I think we can take the opportunity of our civilized communication system to broadcast what we know to each other, in order to profit each other, in order to elevate our earth mental consciousness into a higher level of understanding in order to make our earth into a heaven. We no need to immigrate into another planet or to Nirvana if we make our world become a paradise.
观的观众，感谢您亲切而安详地观赏今天的智慧之影节目。